So we were thrilled when Metacritic named us the top publisher in the industry with the highest overall review scores across all of our games. But tonight is about the future. We're here to show you where we're headed and the games that we're creating that you'll soon be playing, the worlds that you'll be inhabiting in the next year and beyond. So, we're starting with a game that we announced a few weeks ago through our friends at Walmart Canada. Perhaps best known for their low prices and ability to keep a secret. So let's get things started with a look at Rage 2.
What's up, game players? How are you guys doing? Man, welcome to the Analog Circle Podcast. This is the greatest week in video games, man. E3 week is the pinnacle. This is the week that all of us game players look forward to each and every single year. It is the Super Bowl of gaming. And I must say that it has grown over the years. All of these third-party publishers have started doing their own conferences. And my goodness, it would not be right if I did not cover one of my favorites this year. First off, I want to apologize for having them on the back burner. This was not right of me, but so many conferences happening. It's only so much time in a day. So I want to welcome you guys to this special edition of Bethesda's E3 2018 conference. Now, this one got me excited, okay? Man, I was pumped up and ready. So without further ado, let's get into it. I understand EA had theirs. I saw EA's. I don't even think we need to really cover EA's this year. What do you guys think? Do you think so or you think not? Let me know. You can do that, of course, by calling in at 443-216-9934. I'm all messed up right now. Or email the show at the Analog Circle Podcast at gmail.com. So, Bethesda. Woo! One of the big publishers out there, and one of the big developers as well. They took to the stage. This was on Sunday, so I'm literally 2 days late, but we gonna cover it because we got to. It has some greatness going on. Okay, so up first on the stage, Mr. Pete Hines took to the stage, who was the global senior president. Now, after he talked and welcomed everybody and said Walmart, our good friends over at Walmart, like to leak information, they leaked some stuff on us, that's when we get our glimpse of their first game during the E3 press conference. And my goodness, this is a game that I'm looking so forward to. And it is Rage 2. Now, the band came out and they got going. They just got right into it and bam, they were out the gate playing some great tunes and everything was, you know, real fired up right now. I think the name of the band was Andrew WK. I think that was their name. But as they're playing and getting the crowd into it and everybody at the end, woo, you know, cheering and whatnot, they started showing off. The first part of the game they started showing was the driving combat. And God dog, man, it really looks great. Being out there on the desert, you got guns on the front of the doggone, what is it, man? I don't know if it's a dune buggy or a car. I don't know. But it's out there in the desert, you're shooting up cars. He jumps out of the car. I mean, seamlessly now, jumps out of the car. He's in first person mode and then the gun start. Oh, you see the gun play? The gun play looks great in this game. In this game, the thing that gets me excited, I gotta say this, the thing about this game that gets me pretty pumped up is it looks like the physics are gonna be good. Looks like the physics on the character models, you're throwing them, they're getting flung over doggone boxes and walls and whatnot. Oh, this is gonna be epic. This is gonna be great. So as that's going on, I'm all excited and pumped up because I think this is the closest thing that I'm gonna get to a game that looks somewhat like Bulletstorm. And I know you guys are tired of me talking about Bulletstorm, but I'm gonna keep talking about it until somebody out there makes a god doggone sequel. Game was highly underrated. So I'm looking at Rage 2, I'm pumped up, and then before it ends, they say that the game will be released in spring of 2019. I gotta tell you guys, man, I have to reiterate this. I have to say this again. This, not this year, next year is going to be a full house, man. You hear me? Of games, I mean from everybody. From Sony, from Nintendo, from Microsoft, from third parties. Everybody's coming out next year. I mean, think about it. Kingdom Hearts 3 is the first game up on the docket. I believe that comes out January 29th, a AAA game. And February is filled. You got Crackdown 3 that's supposed to be in February. Then you got Days Gone, that is supposed to be coming out in February. And it's another game that I can't think of right now that's coming out in February. It's going to be stacked. So after that game left the stage, and I was so excited because, man, I can't wait for that one. Up next was Elder Scrolls Legends. Now, this game, I'm not into it. My excitement level, it didn't, die down, but only because it's not a game for me. This is not me at all saying that people that are into this game shouldn't be excited. You should be darn excited because they left some really cool announcements on the stage with this one. They said that this game is going to be getting a graphical overhaul and it's going to be available, of course, on the PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and the Switch. Now, this is a card game, okay? That's why I'm not that excited. I know I got all pumped up when I said the Switch, like it was something big, but it just isn't for me. Card games aren't my thing. I never got into The Witcher 3's, I forget the name of that Gwent, I think it's called, on The Witcher 3. Not really my type of game. But up next, you know, I forgot the gentleman's name who took to the stage, but he came to the stage to talk about Elder Scrolls Online. And I mean, I did not know this. Elder Scrolls Online seems to be doing quite well. They continue to bring expansions to it, and you know, it's a big player base and they're doing fantastic. So for anybody that's into Elder Scrolls Online, you guys have to know that more content is coming. They're continuing to show their support for this game, and it looks like it's not going to be dying down anytime soon. So after that, God dog, here we go again. Man, on the merry-go-round. Now, they announced Doom Eternal, which is actually a sequel to the remake of Doom that came out this generation on the PlayStation 4, on the Xbox One. Finally, we are getting a sequel. Now, I own Doom. I own this game, and god darn, the gameplay is buttery smooth. Oh, the gunplay is smooth. Graphics look fantastic. So I am really, really excited about this. Now, this is the kicker. It's going to be twice the enemy types, two times more enemy types on the screen. They will be, and they're going to be debuting this game at, QuakeCon in August. So for anybody that's a Doom fan, that has been a Doom fan since the PC days, yeah, we talking about 94, 95-ish? Kind of years for Doom? Yeah, brother, get ready, man, because in August, they're gonna hopefully give us a lot more information. I want to see some gameplay. I mean, because some of those takedowns were brutal in doggone Doom, so this got me so doggone excited. Now, After they talked about Doom, they didn't say too much more. They didn't give a release date or a release window. But like I said, I'm guessing in August, that's when all of that's going to take place. So next up. Oh, yeah. Joshua. Yeah, you guys might know or might not know Joshua, but he is the community manager of Quake Champions. Now, I made it sound like I know Joshua. I don't know this brother. I don't know this guy, but he took to the stage and he started talking about Quake Champions, and he took to the stage to discuss some of the things that'll be going on with the game. Now, he said it will be a free trial at Quake.com if you play this week. No, hold on. Let me see. I wrote this all wrong. Wait a minute. Now, he was saying that, it's a free trial. All you got to do is go to Quake.com to download it. Now, this is only available for the PC. Now, if you guys get out there and you, download it, you can play it this week. But the kicker is, even after this week, you'll be able to play it after the trial closes. So for anybody out there that has a PC that's a Quake fan, definitely go over there at Quake.com again, download this free trial, and play until you smile, god dog, and enjoy yourself. Now, after that was shown, next up, this was another interesting one. Very interesting. The next game up was Prey. Which actually is getting a free update that is actually available now. So if any of you guys that have already seen this conference, you know this, you've downloaded it, and you're excited and enjoying it, hopefully. But as far as this free update, what's going to be included in this, they actually added three new modes. They added story mode. I'm taking it. This has to be. Nah, it's just called story mode. Story mode. They have a new game plus mode and survival mode. So three new modes in there for free right now. Go ahead and do what you do. Now, they also are releasing DLC that's called Moon Crash. Now, it will be different. This is the thing. I think this is going to be procedurally generated because it's going to be different each time you play. Now, the DLC is actually out right now, which is crazy. God darn, you talk about some bombs being dropped for people who are Prey fans. This is absolutely fantastic. They're giving you a lot of bang for the buck. Now, that wasn't the only announcement, because up next, they announced, Typhon Hunter will be out later this summer, where you will be able to play as a mimic. Woo! How interesting is that gonna be? I heard that mimics can be chairs, they can be a glass of water. You just don't know what it can be, and you're gonna be going up against three other players and trying to figure out where they are. This is interesting. I'm pretty excited. I think I need to pick up Prey. What do you guys think? I don't know. Now, moving on after that, this one right here, brother. This one really, really, really made me wipe my brow, because I started sweating when I saw this. Now, next up was Wolfenstein. Oh, man. You guys know I enjoyed Wolfenstein 2. I thought it was really, really great. Thought the gameplay was good. It was kind of hard, though. The game was a little tough. I mean, it looked good. Gameplay was good. Story was actually quite good as well. I mean, god dog. They did good. They did good. That's all I can say. I'm stuttering like a mother lover. But anyway, let's get into it. Now, they actually said that they will be releasing Wolfenstein 2 on the Switch on June 29th. Man, this is all I can say. I mean, I did the Nintendo conference, not too long ago, a couple minutes ago, probably, maybe a half an hour or so. But, I was saying how I appreciate that Nintendo is actually getting this third party support. And this just goes into what I'm saying. Nintendo is a different Nintendo with this Switch. The Switch is getting a lot of third party love and support. And Bethesda has definitely been giving Nintendo a lot of that love. Oh man, you feel it in the air. So after this, they also announced, which got me excited. This is the part that got me pumped up. It's going to be a new chapter in the Wolfenstein franchise. Now, the name of this chapter or this DLC or, you know, this expansion. Oh, this is taking an interesting turn. I didn't see. Now, this is going to be called Wolfenstein Young Blood. Oh, yeah. Now, it's going to feature Blazkowicz's twin daughters. God darn it. Showing them hitting a punching bag. They getting ready. They talking about, let's do it like Papa told us to do it and all of this other stuff. I think they about to get it in, man. And the very, very cool thing about this is, it's going to be co-op for the first time. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but for the first time, a Wolfenstein game is going to be co-op. This is fantastic. Now, the game setting, as far as what year it's going to be set in, it's going to be set in the 1980s, and the game or the DLC, I don't know, or the add-on, whatever you want to call it, man. It might be a standalone game. It's going to release in 2019. Man, all I can say, you know, you can hear Blazkowicz talking in the background saying he's fought all of these long, hard years. And, you know, he's just put his life on the line, you know, constantly. And it was their time to do what they had to do. His daughters. I want to know where Blazkowicz is. I don't know if he's still living, if he passed away from old age. I mean, I don't know. It's like more questions for me than answers. But what I do know is this is definitely one that I'm going to pick up. Co-op is fantastic. Me, you guys know I'm not online like that, so it doesn't really affect me that much. I'm just excited that it's another continuation in the Wolfenstein universe that's about to happen, and they're going to the next generation, which is very interesting. So I can't wait to see how this comes out in the wash, man. Now, moving on, up next, this was interesting. And like I said, VR, I'm on board. I know a lot of other people are not on board for VR, but for me personally, I think VR is a fantastic peripheral. So, up next in this section, of course, like I alluded to just a second ago, it was the VR section. Now, they showed off Prey, which will have a VR game, which is going to be called, this is the Typhon Hunter. Now, there will be a Wolfenstein VR game as well. It's going to be called Cyber Pilot, where you're taking over, I believe, Nazi aircrafts or ships and turning them against the Nazis and shooting them up to obliteration and all of that good stuff. So, I mean, they look okay. They look pretty okay. Nothing crazy, nothing insane. I mean, I don't know. They didn't really show it off too much, so I'm going off of my imagination and thinking that this probably is going to be quite cool. Now, this is the thing. I do not know if this is going to be on the PlayStation VR. I don't know if it's going to be on the Oculus Rift, and I don't know if it's going to be on the what is the other one? The Vive, the HTC Vive. I'm not sure if they're coming out on all three of those peripherals or if it's just going to be on the Vive and not on the PlayStation VR and, you know, the other peripheral, the Oculus Rift. We'll have to see. They didn't really go into any details about that. So hopefully we'll find something out very, very soon. But after that, this is pretty much the end of the conference almost. But of course, man, the guy, the legend over there who's been with Bethesda for, I didn't know it was this long, but 25 years. Gee whiz. Todd Howard came out on the stage and, man, he had a lot to daggone say. Of course, you know, everybody wanted to know about, you know, Skyrim, and they made the little joke with the, I think it was the Keen guy, the guy from Keen and Peele, the light-skinned brother. He was up there, you know, talking to, Siri or somebody through the Amazon speaker, acting like the game was real and whatnot. It was a nice little bit, kind of funny. Let's move on, you know, but it was all right. But after that, Todd Howard started talking about the game that everybody has definitely been wondering about over the last, what would you say, about a week and a half, maybe 2 weeks, and that was Fallout 76. Oh, man. Now, I got to admit, okay, I don't want to be a faker. I don't want to be the guy that's on Front Street right now. I have never been the biggest Fallout fan, but I have to say, I just picked out Fallout 4 last week, and I'm very, very interested and anticipating getting into that world because it looks like it's a lot of lore. So it is definitely a game that I'm interested in, which leads me to this game, which is Fallout 76, because hopefully if I enjoy 4 enough, I want to get into the 76 joint. Now, he said it will be set. Now, this is very, very interesting. I love the fact that it's going to be set in West Virginia. Very, very interesting setting because you don't hear about a lot of East Coast places being displayed in games outside of New York City. For the most part, everything on the East Coast is New York. Or, I can't even say Washington. Maybe they have hints of Washington, D.C. here and there in the game, but it's never completely centered in D.C. But for them to go to West Virginia, which is, I've been to West Virginia. It's somewhat of a, it's a rural place. It has a lot of rural places up there when I'm delivering freight. You know, it's interesting. It's a coal mine city or coal mine state from my understanding. Don't know a lot about West Virginia, but anyway, man, I'm going off on some other bull crap right now. That's not even the point. But, Todd started, going into detail. Now, this is where it gets interesting for you Fallout fans. You Fallout, what I would call Fallout, enthusiasts. Now, he says that, this game is gonna have 16 times the detail of any other games. He also announced that the game is entirely online. Now, this is what everybody was talking about. They all speculated that this game was gonna be online. And yes, you guys were absolutely right. That is where it lives. Online. Now, he continued on and said, you can still, now this was the part that really made me interested in this game. He said that you can still play the game solo, but the game's big focus will be co-op. He also said that if you're going at it solo, you're gonna have a bit of a hard time. You're gonna have some rough moments. It's gonna be tough to take down certain enemy types. So you might want to think about teaming up, but nonetheless, it's not impossible. You can play it solo. So that was pretty cool. I like that. Now, he also went on to say, even though you die, it doesn't mean that you lose your progression. And when you play with your friends, your progression will carry over, which is really cool because I know that a lot of people out there that are playing State of Decay 2, they've said that they don't like the fact that they helped their friend out and they, you know, doing all of this stuff, helping him build up his community and all of these other items and stuff, that they don't get to take those goodies to their game. So this is a very, very good thing. Him saying that, you know, any progress you make in the game, no matter who it's with, if it's with three of your friends, one of your friends, two of your friends, your progression will carry over into your personal game. That's sensational. He also said, I'm just going off the cuff right now. He said that they're going to have dedicated servers, which is also a big thing. Dedicated servers, man, which once again, definitely not browbeating State of Decay, but that has been a bit of a problem for the game. They don't have the servers. I don't know why Microsoft didn't give it to them. What the? Anyway, let's move on. Now, You will also be able to control. Now, this was cool, man, because, you know, they had the Pit Boy, you know, walking around and doing a little demos of different things and how they work going into the wasteland. I forget his name, but he was out there, you know, talking about, you know, the Atoms. And I like the fact that he's in color. The Joker's in darn color. He ain't in black and white no more. He got money. He's in color right now. So he's going around and he's also, you know, demonstrating how the world works. We all know how the Fallout, you know, presentation goes. It's kind of funny, actually. But they also talked about being able to control the Atom. So you can actually bomb, I mean doggone bomb, your enemies straight out the gate. Now, it could be a positive or it could be a negative, because you don't know. You might not necessarily bomb out your enemies. You might take out some wildlife. You might mess around and just do a dud. They might have got up out of there. You never know. But nonetheless, the choice is yours, which is all the better. Now, there is going to be a beta one day. I don't know when. You got to sign up for the beta and all of that good stuff. But outside of that, they went over the special editions. Now, I must say, man, Bethesda does a fantastic job at their special editions. I saw that Pip-Boy watch and I was like, God darn, that is freaking cool. I would love to get that, you know, but I didn't get it. I mean, I was faking on it, but I definitely would have loved to have had that. If I was a Fallout fan, tried and true, that would have been an absolute day one purchase, because I think you put your phone in there. Anyway, going off on another tangent again. Let's get back on track, Kiaun. All right. So they went over the special editions that will include a map of the world that glows in the dark. Woo. Oh, man. Now, I'm saying that a little, I don't really mean that it's that amazing, but it's cool though. It glows in the dark. It's green. That's pretty cool. It is cool, man. I think it's great. And also it's going to come with some figures that you can put on the map. Now, after that, the biggest thing to me, which was the coolest thing ever, man, was this special edition is going to come with the Fallout Brotherhood mask. And it was talking about having some features of being able to alter your voice under the mask and some more stuff. Now, I was thinking, now, I don't know, because, you know, my imagination, it does go way off left a lot of the time, not sometime, most of the time. But I was thinking, man, what if this thing is big enough to fit on your head, man, and you can just walk around and just be saying different commands and stuff through it and acting like you're one of the Brotherhood or whatever. Cosplay, I guess, is what came to mind. I have never done cosplay, but hey, maybe Halloween, because I remember a couple of years ago, they had an Optimus Prime mask. This thing was really freaking cool. You put it on, and when you talked with the mask on your face, it actually changed your voice to sound like Optimus Prime. Man, as I was saying, brother, God dang, sorry about the unprofessionalism out here, man. But let me wrap this up. Now, the last thing they said was the game is going to be coming out on November 14th. It's going to be coming out, ha ha ha, of course, for the all of the systems, Xbox One, PlayStation 4, PC, and all of that good stuff. But that wasn't the only announcement. Big announcement, but not the only one. They also said that Fallout Shelter will be coming to the Nintendo Switch and the PlayStation 4, and they're available now, and they are absolutely for the price of $3.99. Now, after that, another game was announced. Now, this game is set in the Elder Scroll universe. It's going to be called Elder Scroll Blades, and it's a first-person action game. You're swinging the sword with your finger. They had some ideas. Of course, Todd Howard said, this does not do the game justice. You need to see the game on your iPhone. My thing was, Todd, Where is the love for the Android, brother? What about the Android users? I guess we just get nothing right now. But who cares? You gave me greatness on my consoles, so I'm happy for that. But that pretty much wrapped up their conference. Let me clear my throat. Hold on. Man, oh man. That was pretty much it. Now, I can rate their conference. I think that Bethesda, they did a great job. They had some really good games that I'm looking forward to. I'm really looking forward to the Wolfenstein, what's it called? Youngblood or New Blood? I can't think of the name of it at the moment because I'm flying off the cuff right now. I'm looking forward to that. That's going to be a fantastic game. Youngblood. Yeah, Youngblood. I'm looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to the new Doom game. I think that's going to be fantastic. The sequel. And I'm looking forward to Rage 2 as well. So I would have to say that for me personally, and even though I'm not a fan, Fallout 76 does look really, really cool, to be fair. So for me, I would say I would give them a solid B. I don't think they really did anything wrong. I think theirs were great. I mean, theirs was a great conference. And I couldn't ask for any more. It's a third party publisher. They can only show you so much. So I appreciated what they showed me, and I thought they got a solid B. I mean, man, this E3 this year, they really, nobody outside of EA, I gotta say, god dang, and even they had some bright spots. I mean, Anthem looked okay. It didn't look as good as that E3 trailer from last year. You can tell it got toned down quite a bit. But, you know, outside of that, they had the other game, the indie game that's coming out. Unravel 2 is out right now, which that was a big, pleasant surprise. So, I mean, EA, even though, it was a struggle to look at EA's, they still had some bright spots. But getting back to Bethesda, I think, like I said, it was a B. I don't think anybody this year for their player base, and I mean, I'm excluding EA from this, you know, theirs is very subjective, man. But, I think that Bethesda, you know, they didn't drop the ball. Nobody really dropped the ball this year. And I have to say that I know I spoke about, Sony's conference a little earlier today. I don't think, I have to go back to the drawing board with that, because I looked at it again. I watched it again, and it's no way I could give Microsoft a B and give Sony a C+. That's just kind of biased, in my opinion, because Sony did what they said they were going to do. And it's not fair for me to hold my expectations as to what I thought they should have shown versus what they told me they were going to show. So I would also have to give Sony a B. I think it's a soft B. It's not a hard B like Microsoft's is for me, but it's a soft B, because the games that they showed, I mean, outside of Death Stranding, I just, man, I don't know. It just doesn't look like my kind of game, but It's the first real gameplay we've seen. I get tired of Kojima doing these riddles and all of this stuff, and some people love it, and it's cool to a certain point. And after a while, it just becomes annoying. But that's just me. That's a personal problem for me. But soft B for Sony, just going back over it again. Because their games did look great. I mean, even though Death Stranding, like I said, I'm still confused, it still looks like a really good game. So, with that being said, guys, man, you know what? This is going to be the last one. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to give my impressions also on Square Enix right now. Square Enix, they did okay. They had some bright spots. They, talked about Shadow of the Tomb Raider, which looks fantastic. I'm really, really looking forward to this one. I can't wait to be able to buy it this September. Another September release. Fantastic looking. The trailer that they showed for their Final Fantasy Online game, I'm not a fan of that at all. So it doesn't really make me any difference. I don't really have any input on that. But once again, they did show off, and I have to make a retraction here from the, Xbox press conference. Kind of a retraction, but not really. I got this a little wrong. The game that I was telling you guys, Captain Spirit, which I was saying was by the guys, you know, from the Life is Strange team. Yes, it is from them, but this game is also set in the Life is Strange universe, which is cool. I'm looking forward to downloading that game as soon as it comes out and playing it, because if it's what I think it is, it's going to be a very nice, happy kind of game, man. I'm looking forward to it, to be able to remember those kid days of wonder and thinking you could be a superhero and your imagination just running wild. So I thought that was cool. They talked about Dragon Quest II. That's coming out, in September 4th. I thought that was okay, you know, cause I know it's a lot of Dragon Quest fans out there. That's great fan service for your fans. Babylon Falls. I don't know what that is. I know it's by Platinum Games and it's coming out in 2019. So we'll have to see, you know, what that's about. Platinum Games is behind it. That's already a toss up, brother. I don't know. Sometimes Platinum delivers and sometimes they fall short. So the jury's out on this one until we get more information and really get some real footage of the game. But, Nier Automata was shown. That's awesome. It's coming out to Xbox later on this month. They talked about, I talked about this during the Nintendo joint, the Switch exclusive. I didn't know it was going to be an exclusive, but the name of the game is, Octopath Traveler. Once again, that's coming out the 13th of July. So that's cool. And, this is almost the end of the show. They showed Just Cause 4. I mean, the game looks good. It really does. It looks really good. And that's what sucked me into the third one until I got into the gameplay. And it was just terrible. It was terrible. But nonetheless, for the guys out there that enjoy it, I'm getting tongue tied, that enjoy the game, is coming out, the 4th of December. I believe that's when the third one released, sometime in December when it came out. But outside of that, they showed another game that, now this looks interesting. It's called The Quiet Man. Now he looks like a superhero. I don't know, but he looks normal. You know, well, I guess superheroes do look normal for the most part, but, he just start beating up these random guys. But the thing that was a bit of a, I don't know, I kind of put my hand up, like kind of to stop it in the hand motion, like, I don't know, was if they're going to do that video game kind of thing, similar to Quantum Break. I did not like that about Quantum Break. It was okay, but I would have rather they had just put all of that into the game, really. So I don't know, jury's out on that one, we'll see. But then the last game, of course, that they showed was, Kingdom Hearts. I've beat this one to death and so have they. Kingdom Hearts has been everywhere this year. But nonetheless, once again, it's going to be out January 29th. I thought that conference was, man, you know, maybe a C minus, maybe. I mean, it just wasn't a lot there. I mean, a lot of stuff I wasn't interested in outside of Tomb Raider and, Captain Spirit. And, that was pretty much it for me, but you know, that's just my opinion, but that's going to wrap it up for this one. The Ubisoft conference, I might get around to doing that one a little later, but we'll see. But, until the next time, like I say, phone number will be down in the description if you want to call in and be on the next official podcast, you know, getting your opinions across. If you think Bethesda and Square Enix did a good job, you can definitely feel free to call in. Here's the number, 443-216-9934. Call in, let your voice be heard, and it will definitely be played on the next podcast. So until the next time, you guys take care, be safe out there, and remember, it's not about the consoles, it's about the games.